A little over a month ago, I watched a new interview with Charlie Sheen on the Knockin' Doors Down recovery podcast. Charlie Sheen was one of my favorite actors when I was growing up. I probably watched Major League more than 25 times and never got sick of it. In this video, you're going to learn about a powerful relapse prevention technique for early recovery, which Charlie Sheen uses as one of his tools to stay addiction-free. Charlie Sheen's relapse prevention tool is super legit and based on human behavior, neuroscience, and psychology. First, we're going to listen to a 90-second audio clip of Charlie Sheen talking about his shame shiver relapse prevention technique. Then we're going to break down the process and I'm going to teach you why it works so well and how it can work for you too.
What I have a montage of, and I have like these three that I go to that I'm not, just because I don't want to incriminate anybody else. I can't really describe what they are, but yeah, there are moments that I hang on to that if I decide, all right, it's been a few years, you know, that maybe it wasn't that bad, and these are now brought up. Like if you messed up, one just slides up, and it's like, it creates what I call shame shiver. Sometimes a shame shiver can be an asset to prevent you from, if I can feel something from that long ago as though it just happened because of how it made me feel after, if I can use that. You know, if that moment created so much pain and destruction and dismay, then okay, I own that moment. It doesn't inform my choices today. It doesn't dictate what I, you know, how I'm perceived, whatever. But if I had to go through that to own that image, that experience, then hell yeah, I'm going to keep it close by and call on it if I decide I got a better plan than what I'm doing today.
Now let's break down this process. Charlie Sheen says that anytime he gets an urge to use addictive substances he has sworn off, he activates the shame shiver. Here is the three-step framework of Charlie Sheen's shame shiver process. 1. A thought, impulse, or urge to use drugs and/or alcohol occurs. 2. He notices the urge, yet instead of giving into it and compulsively acting on it as he often did in the past, he shifts focus from negative thinking and fantasizing about using to feeling gratitude for everything good in his life. 3. To systematically and quickly deactivate the craving or urge or thought to use, Sheen transports his consciousness into his mental movie theater and plays a series of three montages. These montages are the three most shameful events from his addiction. These mental reruns are so realistic, Sheen says they cause him to shiver with shame, which makes perfect sense as research has shown that our brains cannot perceive the difference between a real event and something intensely imagined. In Sheen's case, those events did take place and he's simply accessing those memories to access the feelings of shame he knows will help him stay off alcohol and drugs. And did you know that pain avoidance drives human behavior? Everything we do in life is either to avoid pain and or gain pleasure. And we will often do much more to avoid pain than we will to gain pleasure. The shame shiver is a technique that taps directly into the brain software of human behavior via the pain-pleasure principle. When Charlie Sheen uses the shame shiver, his three montages invoke so much shame, a form of pain, that he physically shivers. That pain is real, and he feels it, associates using alcohol and drugs to causing that pain, and since he links so much pain to drugs and alcohol after doing the shame shiver, that pain is enough for him to avoid using drugs and alcohol. To change any behavior in life, you must associate massive pain to doing the behavior and massive pleasure to abstaining from the behavior. If you link more pleasure to the behavior than pain, it'll likely be impossible to quit or at least stay quit. However, if you're able to rewire your brain permanently to associate massive pain to the behavior, e.g. drinking alcohol, using drugs, gambling, or compulsively shopping, and massive pleasure to the benefits and lifestyle of not engaging in the behavior, you'll have a much easier time abstaining from that behavior for life. Here is the formula. The behavior you want to abstain from equals massive pain, and not engaging in the behavior equals massive pleasure. Here's a pro tip. The best neuro associations for abstaining from a behavior are to link a 10 out of 10 pain to the behavior and a 10 out of 10 pleasure to staying clear of the behavior. The worst neuro associations would be a 0 out of 10 pain linked to the behavior and a 10 out of 10 pleasure associated with it. Shame can act as a trigger for many individuals to use alcohol and or drugs to numb the pain of shame. Shame is a painful feeling of humiliation or distress caused by the consciousness of wrong or foolish behavior. However, Sheen teaches us that shame goes both ways, and he has learned how to activate deep feelings of shame at will, then link the negative feeling state to using booze, blow, and other drugs, which helps him to avoid relapse and thus avoids future shame. Finally, it's important to note that the shame shiver won't work for everyone. For individuals that haven't done anything highly shame-invoking, this probably won't work. Additionally, it's not a technique you want to be dependent on forever. The key is to design a healthy lifestyle and routine and keep making progress in recovery so that eventually you no longer experience urges, impulses, cravings, or thoughts to use substances or engage in behaviors you've committed to abstaining from. But that can take some time and consistency. But luckily, until that day comes, now you have one more asset to build up your overall recovery capital. And if you have any shameful events from your past that were caused by drinking too much alcohol or using drugs or another behavior you've committed to abstaining from, now you know how to use the shame shiver for relapse prevention. And as far as I'm concerned, when Charlie Sheen stated he was winning, he was actually losing health, credibility, trust, reputation, friends, film roles, dignity, brain cells, teeth, and more. And after watching his recent interview on the Knockin' Doors Down Recovery podcast, it seems to me that Sheen understands this better than anyone. In the interview, Sheen mentioned that he'd like to get acting roles again because he feels this is his gift to contribute to the world. I wholeheartedly agree. However, in my opinion, even though he's not starring in blockbusters or hit shows these days, while his brother Emilio Estevez is starring in the new Mighty Ducks movie by Disney, the fact that he's addiction-free, staying on that path despite how hard it can be, and even sharing the story on podcasts, that is true winning.